Hello, welcome to 20B, and welcome to the first edition of our new sports show, Night Zone. I'm Leo Dea.
And I'm Steve Gillespie. And this is the first ever edition of Night Zone, an innovative new sports show from 20B.
Yes, we have stories from swimming, football, cross country, soccer, and many more, with interviews with players and coaches. Let me hand it to Steve for our first story.
The soccer team is off to a shaky start, but are working hard to improve themselves on and off the field. Eric Weiss recently asked Coach Comiskey what he felt about the team.
I will be interviewing the Oak Creek High School boys varsity soccer coach, Mr. Comiskey, and we'll ask him about how the team is doing so far this year. How do you feel the team is doing so far this year?
Pretty well. We're a young team, and we've definitely taken some lumps, but like with any team, you kind of work with what you have and hope to improve. And I honestly feel every game so far, we have improved.
What are your expectations for the team this year?
Expectations? I'm going to talk about it later when I talk about the conference, but the conference, as I told the boys here today, it's wide open. So we have a very good chance within our division of finishing anywhere from third or second place.
How does this year's team compare to last year's team?
It's somewhat a rebuilding season. We had a lot of seniors on last year's team, and actually very few seniors on this team. So that's what's exciting about a young team is seeing what can happen in the future. Obviously, I still want to do well this year, but there's a lot of room for improvement. But I honestly feel, compared to last year's, by the end of the year, I bet we'll do better.
And then how is the opposition this year?
The conference, it's kind of wide open. There's no strong teams. Perhaps Kenosha Tremper perhaps might be the strongest team. But I was just looking at some scores today, and as I told the boys earlier, it's wide open. And honestly, anybody can take the conference title.
Have you got a chance to go and watch any of the soccer games this year yet?
I haven't seen any of the Oak Creek High School soccer games, but I did watch a lot of World Cup this year.
Me too, yes. I found that very interesting.
Yes, I think soccer is really swell.
Yeah, it's really on the upswing of the United States and every other country, I think.
Yeah, although not as popular here as in other countries, it's gaining ground. I think it'll be a contender.
Yes, I agree. It's getting very popular. Yeah, Mr. Comiskey is a great coach.
Yes.
Okay. Hey, did you watch that game last night?
Yeah, I did.
That was some great commentary, wasn't it?
Yeah, it was.
Well, here's the K&K connection to tell us more about Oak Creek football.
Coming off a 13-1 state runner-up performance last year, the Oak Creek Knights still prove that they are a formidable force in the Southeast Conference. The 3-0 Knights are battling this Friday against South Milwaukee for sole leadership of the South Division in the Southeast Conference.
Here with star kicker, punter, tight end, Dan Gutlewski. He's a great guy, too. So, Dan, what's your predictions for this week's game?
We're going to win.
By how many?
A lot.
Are you going to score a touchdown?
Yeah, two.
If you do one thing for this game, will you please kick me a 28-yard field goal?
I'll try. I will.
And catch me a touchdown pass.
All right.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
I love you.
I love you more.
Okay. I'm here with all-star free safety, Noah Paquin. Very muscular man. And... and he has been injured the last 2 weeks. And Noah, when are you coming back?
Hopefully 2 weeks.
So, 2 weeks?
Yes.
What date exactly?
I don't even know.
What time of day?
Thank you for this interview.
What time of day will you decide when you're coming back? Noah Paquin. What time are you coming back?
I don't know.
Mike Gaynor, right guard of the esteemed Oak Creek Knights football team. Mike, what are your thoughts on the season so far?
I think the season's going pretty well so far. The morale of the team's very high. We're all starting to get along a lot better. I think we're lacking one major thing, and that would be a Leo Dea.
Mike, what are your predictions for the upcoming week here?
Everybody in here?
Oh, at least 40-7.
40-7, huh?
Yes.
Well, keep in mind, that's against South Milwaukee, going for first place. They're going to be a tough team, eh?
Yeah, they're a lot better team than last year. They're already 2-1. Last year, they were 1-2. They got 2 wins under their belt. They're a lot tougher, a lot more confident than they were last year, but we'll knock that right out of them first quarter.
So do you think you guys might have a repeat performance of last year? Maybe a little better this time?
Oh, the potential's there, but potential's a dangerous word.
For Kyle Plasek, I'm Kevin DeWitt. Now back to you.
Wow, the football team looks like they're doing very well, yeah, don't they, Lee?
They do look very well. I got to see a couple of their games, and they are doing pretty good this year.
Are they?
Yes. That was some excellent camera work by Mike Gaynor in that segment right there, though.
It was. I know from experience, those cameras are rather heavy, and I cannot keep my composure and film like that man can.
Oh, he's just extraordinary.
That was very good. Okay, now let's go to Sherry St. Augustine for a look at the cross-country invitational meet at South Milwaukee.
Yes, Meg, she's here.
Dare.
Go, Ben!
That's good.
Go get up!
Keep moving up, Kane!
Come on, Smith! Come on, Smith! Justin!
Okay, we raced at South Milwaukee at the Rocket Invitational. It was a 16-team meet and probably the best quality meet we've had so far this year. It was a hot, humid day. We had some very, outstanding races. We finished in sixth place, and I was really pleased with the way the boys raced.
Could you tell me some key runners?
Okay, the key runners for this week were, number one runner in for us was Ryan Kleinenhagen, who placed fifth. He ran 17:02, which is a personal record for him. And then Dave Conaty is our second runner in, ran 18 flat, followed by Andy Lesser, Derek Hampbark, and Gareth Milkowski, in the top five in the varsity.
Okay, well, thank you for your time.
You're welcome.
Gareth, we were wondering how you did the race.
I PR'd by 15 seconds. I probably could have done better than I did, but I still ran good for the race.
So what place did you finish in for our team?
For our team, I finished fourth overall, 2 seconds behind Andy Lesser.
Was it nice weather?
It was a little hot and muggy, but it was pretty nice over us since we were by the lake.
In the recent 16-team Rocket Invitation, the boys cross country led by Ryan Kleinenhagen placed sixth. The girls cross country team placed eighth at the South Milwaukee invite with Deanna Schmitz leading the Knights. Both Coach Keene and Coach Richmond expect to have a successful as well as fun cross-country season. For Knights Own, this is Sherry St. Augustine reporting.
Yes, the cross-country team is looking rather strong this year with leadership behind Annie Lesser and Gareth Malkowski.
Is that
Randy Wyack's sock from the Invitational meet?
Is it? I don't know. I was going to ask you, but it could be. It very well could be. I just found it laying here on the table.
It's very pretty.
It's soft, too. Smell it once.
Roses.
Does it smell good?
Roses.
Roses?
Roses.
Oh, you're right.
So where can you go to see women in bathing suits without the interruption of the sight of men in spandex? How about our own swimming pool at Oak Creek? Here's Nate Holzman and Ryan Casper with the story.
Hi, I'm Nate Holzman, along with Ryan Casper. We took a look into girls swimming for you guys, and here's what happened. First, we asked people if they thought football or girls swimming was more popular. Here's what happened. Players, can you name off Oak Creek girls swim team?
None.
Do you play?
Julie Wenzel.
There's this one big swim girl who was in my gym class, but I don't remember her name.
Beth Coplin. I think she's in diving, but I think she's on the swim team, so I can name one. But I do know that Oak Creek's won their first two games this year in football. But
none. Anna, one. All right, wait, one more. How many players can you name off the Oak Creek varsity football team?
Oh, like 25 right, million of them. No,
Jason Weinhold, Jeremy Carls, Brian Harmon.
Jess Chappelle, Brian Harmon, Tyler Dea, Jeremy Carls, Brian Cuffren, Josh Carver,
Joe Sabelka, Josh Chappelle, Brian Harmon, Jeremy Carls, Jeremy Gajewski, Todd O'Dea, Mike Wojciechowski, JaVale Allen, Lauren Allen.
None, because I'm brand new. I haven't seen any games yet. I can't even name the people I teach next to.
Now let's go to an interview with none other but the coach of our Oak Creek High School girls swim team. All right, first, how's your season going so far?
It's going real well. We've got a good group of girls here. They're really dedicated workers, and we're looking for a lot of big things out of them come the end of the season.
So how's your season been going as far as wins go?
We haven't been able. We've only had three dual meets. We had our board down for two meets, which kind of cost us winning. But so far, so good. We can hold our own.
Who are some of the girls that you have high hopes for and who might stand out from the rest of them?
Let's see. We have junior Jenny Feather, who is a sprinter. We're looking for hopefully getting a state, get her to qualify for a state this year. We took in a young freshman girl. Her name is Jenny also. She swims a lot of distance, hopefully with some hard work and dedication. Maybe we'll get her there also.
During the meets, how does scoring go? Is it as far as like per win per person, or is it as a team, or how does that work?
Most of it is done on an individual basis. We do have what we call relays, where it does consist of four girls swimming one event. Otherwise, it's all individual.
How do you feel you size up compared to the other schools in our district?
As far as size, meaning numbers?
Quality, how far you think you're going to make it against them?
As far as numbers go, we have a very large team. From what I've seen this year, I'd say we're pretty comparable team size. As far as being able to compete with a lot of your bigger schools like Case and Tremper, Bradford, they have a lot of good swim youth programs, okay, which Oak Creek lacks.
Do you have any arch rivals like South Milwaukee or anybody like that?
No, I'm afraid we don't. The only time we would see those people would be at an invitational.
All right, when's your guys' next home meet?
Our next home meet is the Oak Creek Invite, and that's October 3rd, and we'll be hosting that. So.
All right, sounds like you guys got a good year ahead of you, and good luck on the rest of your season. Thanks a lot.
Oh, that sure was an excellent swimming clip, wasn't it?
Yes, it was. Man.
For some reason, swim reminds me of paint.
Paint?
Yes, I don't know why either.
Powerful swimmers on that team this year.
Yeah.
I didn't get a chance to go to any of the meets, though, but I'm sure looking forward to them.
Me neither. Oh, I mean, I am looking forward to them. I didn't get to go to any of them.
Yes, very nice.
Yeah, they're great. Yes. So, when you think of Oak Creek, what do you think of? Lee went around to see what students thought of Oak Creek.
When you think of Oak Creek, what's the first word that comes to your mind?
And he also sat down with Coach Cook.
The city of Oak Creek is getting well known for its high school athletic football team. I asked a few people what the first word that came to their mind was. What's the first word that comes to your mind?
Just one? Football.
Football.
Well, as you can see, the majority of the schools say that, well, they think of football and they think of Oak Creek.
I recently talked to Coach Cook about the upcoming football season. How well do you think the team was prepared for this season?
I think we're always prepared for the season because we're off-season work. You win your championships in the off-season, so we had a good off-season. Kids lifted hard and did their running, so yeah, we're well prepared.
What were your thoughts on the team's first few outings?
They're exactly as I expected. We're a young team, so I thought they'd be a little shaky. The Lowell Trust East game at first half kind of went the way I was hoping it would, but I knew it worked just because we were young. But now with each game, we're getting more experience and something sharper.
Can you name key players on the offensive and defensive side of the ball?
Key players are always the seniors. I mean, it's really not one individual, it's just the senior leadership. So, you know, obviously the senior quarterback, Jeremy Carls, and then just having Tato Day as our captain in the backfield, he kind of leads the backfield. And of course, the lineman, you have Brian returning, and now along with the other seniors, that's pretty much our leadership there. And then defensively, it's just, like I said, Noah Packwood's our captain and one of our captains, and Lauren Allen. I think that's really where each leadership from. Those are the ones the kids look up to, but then Jason Weigel, of course, returns, and, you know, so secondary-wise gives everybody confidence. But it's the seniors that are the leaders. Those are the most important guys.
All right, what were your thoughts on the Eddie Mumphrey situation?
I was just kind of sad by it. It's unfortunate somebody chose to make those decisions. You know, he not only hurt himself, you know, but, you know, he affects, you know, people make decisions like that, they don't just affect themselves, they affect a lot of people. So, I thought that I was just kind of sad.
Do you have any thoughts on the creatine allegations?
I don't know. It's just, you know, it's just people's opinion, I guess. There's nothing, obviously, you can buy it anywhere. It's produced by your body, and it's, you know, so it's a natural nutrient. It's found in all your foods. Every time you have meat up in the cafeteria and you have your pork sandwich or your whatever, you're getting it. Every time you have the fish fry on Friday, you're getting it. So, you know, each their own. We have a policy now, so really it's kind of useless for me to comment on it because the school has set a policy and it's my job to go along with the policy.
How are your feelings on last year's state championship game? How did it fit with you and the kids?
Well, even though we had a good season, you're always disappointed in losing. You didn't want to lose that last one. And so it left a sour taste in your mouth. I mean, obviously, you look back, I think the seniors look back and say we accomplished a lot, which they did. But for the juniors returning who are now seniors and the coaching staff, you know, it leaves a sour taste in your mouth. And it's something to build on. And I think that's what's going to fuel this team this year to go maybe all the way.
What do you think that Oak Creek football is doing for the community?
I hope it's helping with a little bit of pride. I mean, you know, it's kind of hard to tell. I've taken a poll. I'm not a politician, so I don't know what's going on up there. But, I mean, you'd like to think it helps school pride and you know, and then community pride. So, you know, I hope so. I mean, you know, anywhere we go now, it seems like people, you know, say good things about it. But, you know, I can't control that.
All right. Can you talk about your coaching staff?
You know, well, they it's a good coaching staff. I mean, you know, you win with good kids, and you know, and it goes right up the ladder. Then you have good assistant coaches. So, I mean, starting with Coach Lindemann, who's run the line, you know, has done my line for years, ever since I was back in Dominican. He's been with me now for 8 years, so 9 years. We've been together, we know each other, and that helps a lot. That continuity is just kind of like a family. If you have that, the same people there, it just adds that kind of secure feeling. And so, but with Coach Hubba and Coach Morris, I mean, all the coaches, they just do a nice job. I mean, the biggest quality I look for in an assistant coach is being loyal, you know, and if he's trustworthy, and that's the most important thing. That's what we have. We have a bunch of guys who are hard workers, but the most important thing is I can trust them, and they're very loyal.
Do you have any season projections?
No. We just take one game at a time. If we get South Milwaukee, I know that'll be a tough game, so we're just going to look at that.
All right, thank you.
All right, thanks.
Wow, Lee, that had a lot of great information on it. You did a good job.
Thanks. Yes. That was excellent camera work.
Thank you. I was the cameraman, remember that?
Yes, I do remember. That's very good. Very excellent.
That's pretty innovative,
yes.
Wouldn't you admit?
Yes.
All right.
Last week, Mike Anders sat down with head volleyball coach, Miss McLeod, about the preview of this volleyball season.
What are your expectations for this year's team?
I guess the expectations are
depending on how we've already done. We've already lost two conference games. I expect to win the rest of our conference games, and we have one more tournament left. I expect to win that. As far as postseason play, I assume we'll end up being in the sectionals against Wauwatosa East. And if we win that, then we'll end up going to state. So I think we have a good bid to go postseason, but we have to pass Wauwatosa East first.
All right. Which players on your team this year have emerged as team leaders?
Team leaders, I would say, are my two captains, senior captains, Mary Kaknowitz and Paul Settles. They were voted as team captains. Also, the other team leaders would be junior Jill Meyer. Those are, between the three of them, they're emerging as the on-court team leaders.
All right. And which teams this year in your conference do you think are going to give you the most trouble?
The two teams who we have already played are Muskego and Burlington. We played them last week and the week before, and we already lost to them. They both went to state last year, so I'm kind of expecting those will hopefully be our only losses as far as conference goes. So right now we've kind of already played the best teams in the conference, and I expect to win the rest of them.
All right. And what are your feelings on future volleyball teams?
Considering that we only have two seniors, I expect that we will do better the next year and the following year.
Mr. Mackey, please call the high school office.
Right now, I have three sophomores starting on my team, and a junior, and then a senior. So my seniors are good, but hopefully next year we'll be even stronger.
Thank you very much. That was our interview with volleyball coach Ms. Bickle.
Steve.
The volleyball's over.
No, I was just thinking about potato chips. Because I like to eat them while I watch volleyball. I love volleyball. How about you, Lee? Now we go to Brian Stefanik with an interview with the girls' varsity tennis coach, Don Tolson.
Really successful season. The girls are playing real hard. We're still in contention to win our sectional, divisional, conference tournament. And hopefully we'll get to the point where we can win back-to-back conference championships.
So how does this team compare to last year's?
Losing eight seniors last year left a lot of holes, but we had a real good group of JV players with some returning lettermen, and they seem to have filled in very well.
So is the competition difficult this year?
There are some very tough teams in the Racine Kenosha schools, but we've had some success against them.
We already beat Bradford and Kenosha.
Case and Kenosha Cup.
So when are these two courts?
Well, that's a question that I wish you could help me with, but we've been promised the 1st of September, but I think the weather's pushed us back, so I'm hoping within a week or so we'll be ready.
Are any conference tournaments going to be held on those courts?
The conference tournament, no, but hopefully, possibly in the boys' season or next year, we're going to attempt to have a conference tournament when it's our turn to host, or a subsectional or sectional tournament in the future.
On just this last quad, there was girls playing different positions.
Mm-hmm.
What was that?
The girls have been playing together pretty much, and it's like having cabin fever. I gave them the opportunity to switch some positions, to give some of my younger players a chance to play up, and to give some of the doubles teams an opportunity to switch if they wanted to. They opted for that, and they did very well, and I was real pleased. Sometimes it's good to play with other partners and kind of get away from your partner initially.
So do you think the team is going to the state this year?
Well, I'd like to get at least one team to state, but that's kind of a long road right now. What I'm concentrating on is getting the girls to focus on to win our conference.
Okay, thank you.
Okay.
Wow, girls varsity tennis looks like they're doing very well.
After their conference title last year, I hope they can hold it up this year.
Yeah, tennis really is great, isn't it?
Yes. Now to our rock and roll highlight section. This will be a weekly thing in the night, so we can look forward to that.
Yeah, it's football highlights, right?
Yes, football highlights.
It's they're set to rock and roll music?
Yes.
Great. You know, when I think of rock and roll, I usually think of football. So this is really fitting that we have rock and roll football highlights.
I usually think of potatoes.
They're quite good. I went to Canada once, and they have ketchup-flavored potato chips there. Seriously. Okay.
No, I thought rock and roll highlights.
Yeah. And did you watch Magnum PI yesterday?
Yeah.
Do you watch a lot of TV, Lee?
Yeah.
I watch tons of it.
Yes.
Do you remember the show Herman's Head?
That was pretty good.
Wasn't it good though?
Yes, very good. Did you watch Saved by the Bell yesterday?
Yeah, I watched like 3 times.
Yeah.
Yeah, I saw it was which one? Oh, yeah, it's the one where they pretended to be parents and they had the kids.
Yeah.
And Lisa was allergic to Screech.
That was a very great highlight, rock and roll highlight film, yes.
That was exquisite.
Very. Yeah, I believe them films need a little more puns in them, though.
Yeah. Yeah, but the parts they did have, like with the passing, wonderfully crafted.
Wonderful.
That was really good.
Well, thanks for tuning in to our first edition of Knights on Plan B.
Lee, do you want to do the secret handshake before we leave?
Sure.
It's the first episode, come on.
Sorry.
I mean, you sure?
I'm Lee Whittier.
I'm Steve Gillespie.
Thanks for watching.
Goodbye.